I'd like to welcome all of you to the ShareHim booth at the 59th General Conference session. We have two young ladies here, both college students, and both of them have had an experience in evangelism through ShareHim. So I'm going to turn to the closest one first. And your name is?
Marisa.
Marisa, and last name?
Swisher.
Marisa Swisher, home is in?
Dayton, Ohio.
Dayton, Ohio. Now let's go to you. Why don't you tell everybody your name?
My name is Krista Matteson.
Krista Matteson, yeah. And you are from?
I'm from Loma Linda, California.
Okay, Loma Linda and Dayton. Where are you going to college?
At Southern Adventist University.
I go to Southern as well.
Okay, what are you studying there?
I'm studying social work.
Amazing. And how is it that social work majors don't normally think about doing international evangelistic campaigns? How did that come about? What inspired you to do that?
I've always had a passion for mission work. I did some mission trips in high school. And I heard about the Evangelistic Resource Center that Southern runs and operates in conjunction with ShareHim. And I decided to stand up at an appeal one time at Vespers in response to God's calling to do some mission work with my university. And I found myself in Ghana that summer.
And so that was in 2000?
That was 2007, 2008 school year. And then I went to Ghana in 2008 summer.
Now, Krista.
Yeah?
Didn't I understand you've done two campaigns?
Yes. I've gone to Nicaragua and also to Ghana.
Which one did you go to first?
Nicaragua was first.
And then you said, did you know that you obviously knew each other studying the same major?
Well, actually, I met her in Ghana because we were on the same Ghana trip. But I didn't know her.
Really?
Until Ghana. And then afterwards, I found out she was doing social work.
Amazing. Yeah. Okay, now let's go to, where did you go to in Ghana?
In Ghana, I went to the city of Kumasi.
Kumasi. How about you?
I went to Kumasi
also.
In
that area.
Yeah.
Now, Kumasi is the central region.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Away from the coast, and it's the Ashanti tribal capital.
The king lives there.
The king lives there. The Shantahini.
Yeah.
I've met him, okay, on a couple of occasions. Now, let me ask you this question. What did this experience, I want to ask you both the same question. What did this experience of going and preaching, I mean, you are not theology majors.
No.
What did this experience do for you personally, spiritually?
Personally, spiritually. I would say that it helped me understand why I believe what I believe. I've been in the church since I was born. But learning about the different doctrines in such a detailed way and then presenting those to other people really confirmed for me my faith and helped me realize that we have an incredible message to share, even in the United States.
So, what did it do for you spiritually?
Spiritually for me, I've always had a heart for doing missions, and specifically in Africa, doing international work. And as I said, I've gone to Nicaragua, but this time I went to Ghana. God just confirmed that I'm supposed to do work in Ghana.
Fantastic.
When I was there, it was sealed. And so
praise the Lord.
I'm trying now to go to school to finish up, but the ultimate goal is to do international work in Africa.
Praise the Lord. Now, one of the things that you needed to do, preaching a campaign, is make a public call. Ask people to respond. Did that make you nervous at all?
Yeah.
A little bit at first.
Uh-huh.
But then I realized how important it was, and
right.
I just started just praying for the Holy Spirit's power, and God works wonders on people's hearts.
So you saw people respond.
Yes, absolutely.
And they came forward.
Yes.
Yeah.
What did that mean to you? I mean, you know you didn't do that.
Yeah. I think it just brought me to tears at times because I knew that the Lord was using me to do His work. And I'm just a little nobody from Dayton, Ohio.
You know,
who am I?
The phrase you used is the single best phrase. The Lord used me.
Yep.
Yeah.
And that is the experience that sums up why ShareHim exists. That's it. So people in the economically developed world, North America, Western Europe, who are accustomed to a ritual approach, to what it means to be church. We go to church and we do this. But this moves it out of your normal activity routine, and it is in discovering.
Yeah.
What does it mean? God used me.
That's right.
And that's why ShareHim exists. And it's the best possible way of summarizing a personal testimony. Now, let me ask you, if you had somebody else of your classmates, and they came to you and said, do you think I can do this? What would you tell them?
Absolutely, yeah. Yes.
I had a friend, I just helped her and encouraged her to go down to Argentina. And she just got back 3 weeks ago.
Praise the Lord.
She was telling me all about it, and she was so afraid.
You can see, there's nothing the matter with fear, as long as it doesn't stop you
from doing
what God wants you to do. Fear is not a problem. It may stimulate you, but never let it be the basis for saying no to God.
Yeah.
I want to thank you for telling all those folks who have been listening and watching you. I hope it'll encourage other people to try when God calls. God bless.
It.
Thanks so much
thank
for taking
you.
Your time here to talk to us.
Thanks.